Hello, in today's episode we are going to talk about Ankylosaurus. If you are enjoying our content, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click the bell to be notified about our future releases. You can also support us with YouTube Premium membership, which will grant you benefits, such as viewing our videos early, loyalty badges, and access to supporter-only polls. We also have mobile games, available both on Play Store and App Store, which will be linked in description. Ankylosaurus is a genus of armored dinosaur. It lived during the Cretaceous period, about 68 to 66 million years ago, in western North America. A handful of specimens have been excavated to date, but a complete skeleton has not been discovered. Though other members of Ankylosauria are represented by more extensive fossil material, Ankylosaurus is often considered the archetypal member of its group, despite having some unusual features. It was covered in armor plates, or osteoderms, with bony half rings covering the neck, and had a large club on the end of its tail. Bones in the skull and other parts of the body were fused, increasing their strength, and this feature is the source of the genus name, Ankylo meaning fused, and Saurus meaning lizard. Ankylosaurus was the largest known ankylosaurine dinosaur and possibly the largest ankylosaurid. In 2004 it was estimated that the individual with the largest known skull, which is 64.5 centimeters long and 74.5 centimeters wide, was about 6.25 meters long and had a hip height of about 1.7 meters. The smallest known skull is 55.5 centimeters long and 64.5 centimeters wide, and Carpenter estimated that it measured about 5.4 meters long and about 1.4 meters tall at the hips. Average weight of Ankylosaurus was estimated to be between 4.8 tons to 8 tons. The three known Ankylosaurus skulls differ in various details. This is thought to be the result of taphonomy, changes happening during decay and fossilization of the remains, and individual variation. The skull was low and triangular in shape, and wider than it was long. The back of the skull was broad and low. The skull had a broad beak on the premaxilla. The orbits, eye sockets, were almost round to slightly oval and did not face directly sideways because the skull tapered towards the front. The brain case was short and robust, as in other ankylosaurines. First Ankylosaurus fossils were found in 1900 in the Lance Formation in Wyoming, consisting of 77 armored plates. However, they were excavated alongside Tyrannosaurus specimen, and at the time they were assigned as belonging to it. Another Ankylosaurus fossils were found in 1906 in the Hell Creek Formation in Montana, United States. This time they were properly assigned. It consisted of the upper part of a skull, two teeth, part of the shoulder girdle, cervical, dorsal, and caudal vertebrae, ribs, and more than 30 armor plates. In 1910 another expedition discovered an Ankylosaurus specimen in the Scollard Formation by the Red Deer River in Alberta, Canada. This specimen included a complete skull, mandibles, the first and only tail club known of this genus, as well as ribs, vertebrae, limb bones, and armor. In 1947 another fossils were found in that location, and it included the largest known Ankylosaurus skull. A section of caudal vertebrae was discovered in the 1960s in the Powder River drainage, Montana, part of the Hell Creek Formation. In addition to these five incomplete specimens, many other isolated osteoderms and teeth have been found. A prominent feature of Ankylosaurus was its armor, consisting of knobs and plates of bone known as osteoderms, or scutes, embedded in the skin. These have not been found in articulation, so their exact placement on the body is unknown, though inferences can be made based on related animals, and various configurations have been proposed. The osteoderms ranged from 1 cm in diameter to 35.5 cm in length, and varied in shape. The osteoderms of Ankylosaurus were generally thin-walled and hollowed on the underside. Many smaller osteoderms and ossicles probably occupied the space between the larger ones, as in other ankylosaurids. The osteoderms covering the body were very flat, though with a low keel at one margin. The tail club of Ankylosaurus was composed of two large osteoderms, with a row of small osteoderms at the midline, and two small osteoderms at the tip. These osteoderms obscured the last tail vertebra. As only the tail club of one specimen is known, the range of variation between individuals is unknown. The found tail club is 60 centimeters long, 49 centimeters wide, and 19 centimeters tall. Like other ornithischians, Ankylosaurus was herbivorous. Its wide muzzle was adapted for non-selective lowbrows cropping, although not to the extent seen in some related genera. Though ankylosaurs may not have fed on fibrous and woody plants, they may have had a varied diet, including tough leaves and pulpy fruits. Ankylosaurus probably fed on abundant ferns and low-growing shrubs. Assuming it was endothermic, Ankylosaurus would have eaten 60 kilograms of ferns per day, similar to the amount of dry vegetation a large elephant would consume. Carpenter to suggest that ankylosaurids in general, or at least the young, did not swallow their food whole but employed some sort of chewing. Since adult Ankylosaurus did little chewing of its food, it would have spent less time in the day foraging than an elephant. Based on the broadness of the ribcage, the digestion of unchewed food may have been facilitated by hindgut fermentation like in modern herbivorous lizards, which have several chambers in their enlarged colon. The osteoderms of ankylosaurids were thin in comparison to those of other ankylosaurs, and appear to have been strengthened by randomly distributed cushions of collagen fibers. Structurally similar to Sharpie's fibers, they were embedded directly into the bone tissue, a feature unique to ankylosaurids. This would have provided the ankylosaurids with an armor covering that was both lightweight and highly durable, being resistant to breakage and penetration by the teeth of predators. The palpebrile bones over the eyes may have provided additional protection for them. Carpenter suggested in 1982 that the heavily vascularized armor may also have had a role in thermoregulation, as in modern crocodilians. The tail club of Ankylosaurus seems to have been an active defensive weapon, capable of producing enough of an impact to break the bones of an assailant. The tendons of the tail were partially ossified and were not very elastic, allowing great force to be transmitted to the club when it was used as a weapon. Coombs suggested in 1979 that several hindlimb muscles would have controlled the swinging of the tail, and that violent thrusts of the club would have been able to break the leg bones of large theropods.